Hey guys, it's Queen Deja, and in today's video, I will be reacting to episodes 7 and 8 of Descending Stories. Let's go ahead and get started with episode 7 in 3, 2, 1, go. Oh, that was a weird. Okay, but whatever. We're just glad you're okay. Well, duh. That's the typical thing about being in a hospital. I don't know about that. He just had that attack, and you really want him to help you? Excuse me. I mean, practice should be okay, right? I know. Nobody really wants to think about that, but yeah, the day is coming. Still, Shin is still gonna say no. Even with Bond Jr. coming in and being like, please, no. Should have at least asked somebody to help you. You can't be out here. Yep, so you know when that happens, we gotta have something that we didn't need anymore. No. Exactly. We're trying to prevent that from happening again. Thank you. 30 years. Jesus. Were you here that night, though? You saw her again. Those eyes. Never forget those eyes. I figured it made the most sense to show both of them in this. Right. Oh, Matsuda. I know. I miss him too. located still. No. No. Time out. Time out. Oh my God. The ish that we saw in the first. Oh my God. All this time, this changes everything. Yeah. Okay, though. Let him cry today. Oh, okay. Going back to that final episode of Yurie and Bon, their last moments together. And because I think I remember her stabbing him. I don't remember. But they didn't have blood on them. I ain't see that. I don't remember that. But I think she tried to stab him. And then either she got pushed because she did fall back. I do remember that. And he caught her. And of course, Shin went to grab both her and Bon. And he kept telling him, let me go. Like, you can't pull both of us. And in the end, he did. So that was all in his mind. He made that ish up. She stabbed her husband. Daughter came in, seeing the blood of her dad everywhere, and accuses Shin of killing her dad when it was her mom. And then she pushes her mom to the point that the freaking, the railing breaks. And he goes straight for her. And because she's super emotional of that moment and during that moment, she locks it away. And I think even now she still has it locked away because I think she's just scared to really think about the truth of what happened that night. I think any kid, that's emotional trauma right there. Oh, God. I don't know how to feel. That. Oh. That hurt so freaking much. I cannot believe. This changes everything now on how I look at this situation. But it's still truly sad because two people died. They never got to see their child grow. Or even get to see their grandchild. That just fucking hurts. That really, truly hurts. But go ahead and pause the video. And I will see you guys in 1 second for episode 8. Mm-hmm. Okay, episode 8 in 3, 2, 1, go. I'm gonna get a beat. Yeah. Thank you. It's just nerves. You'll do fine. I'm sorry, my Chin. Yeah, get just 100%. You look like him. Complicated. Good question. They're both in there. Shit's in there. There you are. Still trying to find yourself. I mean, that's just crazy to say to somebody, but like, oh, I'm happy that he has them. But I'm like, I mean, it would be good, especially for Shin Jr. to have those, and also, for everybody else to see Bond stuff. But I get it. Bond is just like, A, I want this to stay in the past. I don't want to bring this out. Oh no. You okay? He still hasn't told her the real truth. I get it. You would say this now. You'll see. Yes. I had a feeling. Everything was going so well. He was off to a great start, and then it had to get ruined. But it's like, and I get it. When you feel like you've lost everything, especially your passion of what you were doing that, made you, and something tragically happens to you, and you're like, how do I pick up the pieces to get to back where I once was? It's hard. It truly is hard. Now, seeing the recording of a Bon and Shin, like, was sweet. Very almost therapeutic in a way. It was something that I think all of us needed to see in the previous episode. And for Yato to perform that for his master was very sweet as well. Like, it the feels way too much. And I'm happy. But I'm still sad because we're almost done with this show, and that also means he's probably gonna die by the end of the show. I don't want him to die. I really have nothing else to say. It was good. Both episodes beautifully done, beautifully brilliant in how they were going, but I'm scared. I think with this show, I'm always scared. Like, truly, it's such a damn good series, and it's just like I don't want it to be over. Even that's kind of almost the other reason why I'm taking so long with recording these. But we're getting close to the end, and I don't want to. It's gonna hurt. Why would you? Oh my god, just when he's starting to really get better and he's performing again, now we see snow falling down during his performance. Do not kill him next week, please. Wait until the last episode. Last episode. Kill him off. I love him too damn much. That's all. Last fucking episode. Do it. Not episode 9, damn it. But other than that, guys, that is my reaction view towards episodes 7 and 8 of Descending Stories. If you guys enjoyed it, please give me a like. Really helps me out. Also, subscribe to my channel and make videos if you want to join the Metro Squad. And of course, I will see you guys officially all next Saturday for Patreons and next Thursday for everybody else for episodes 9 and 10. But until then, I will see you guys all next time. Bye.